गुड इवनिंग एवरीबॉडी, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग वेल. इट्स अनदर रेनी डे. आई फील लाइक एवरी टाइम आई डू अ टॉक इट लाइक स्टार्ट्स रेनिंग लाइक क्रेजी. सो अगेन आई होप एवरीबॉडी इज सेफ, एवरीवन इज डूइंग वेल. एंड सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट अ टॉपिक दैट्स नॉट ओनली इम्पॉर्टेंट इन एनिमल हेल्थ, इट्स ऑल्सो वेरी वेरी इम्पॉर्टेंट इन ह्यूमन हेल्थ. इट्स समथिंग दैट we all need to be aware of. It's something that is affecting the entire world right now. I mean, apart from the pandemic, of course, but this is a way bigger problem, and it can lead to a worse impact on things if we just let it be. So today we're talking about antibiotic resistance. All right. So a lot of people have some common misconceptions when it comes to using antibiotics. Now, so first, let's talk about what is an antibiotic. Okay. So an antibiotic is a drug. Okay. It's a compound which was initially, obviously, the first antibiotic that was discovered was penicillin. Now, penicillin was got from a fungus called Penicillium notatum. So penicillin was obviously Alexander Fleming. He discovered that the fungus is able to kill certain bacteria. Okay, so what he did was he extracted the enzyme or the gosh, I'm going into a complete brain fart right now. But so basically, what he did was he discovered penicillin. He found that penicillin was able to kill bacteria, and he used it in certain cases, and he was able to cure people. Okay, so that was how penicillin was first discovered. Okay, and so a lot of these antibiotics were slowly derived, and they were got from different sources. So a lot of them do come from fungus, just like penicillin. Okay. And a lot of them are artificially created. Now, the discovery of antibiotics led to life-saving endeavors, of course, because there were a lot of people dying of what we today consider common infections, because we have antibiotics to treat them. And in those days, of course, people were just dying of these common infections. Now that we have these antibiotics, we're able to control these infections, we're able to overcome this bacteria. Okay, but what has also happened along with this is that there is an overuse or an improper use of these drugs. Okay, so what happens then is that the bacteria, now antibiotics, okay, are to kill or they stop the growth of bacteria. Okay, they are not used for viruses. They do not work against viruses. Antivirals are the ones that work against viruses. All right, so antibiotics are for bacteria. When we talk about antibiotic resistance, we're talking only about bacteria. So what happens in antibiotic resistance? When we overuse an antibiotic where it's not needed. Now, certain cases where it's not needed is the common cold, the flu, just a common cough, which are usually caused by viruses. Now, when antibiotics are blindly taken in these cases, of course, it's not going to work, because it's a virus that is causing this, and the antibiotic is not going to be effective against the virus. And what also happens is that the bacteria that is already present, the good bacteria, gets killed. Now, what also happens is harmful bacteria slowly, as when there is overuse of these antibiotics, the bacteria slowly starts becoming resistant to it. How does it become resistant? It finds ways to maneuver around the action of the antibiotic. Okay, and so suppose you have, for example, there are 10 bacteria, okay, in your system. Now the antibiotic attacks 9 of them, and one manages to escape. So that one has become a resistant bacteria. It has the resistance in its DNA, and that bacteria will multiply, and it's going to lead, and it's going to produce the resistant strain of the bacteria which is going to give rise to the resistant infection. Okay, so when you constantly or just randomly take antibiotics, the bacteria is slowly going to become resistant to that particular antibiotic, and then eventually it's going to take much longer to cure even common conditions which were cured very easily by certain easily available antibiotics, and it's going to increase the length of the illness. It's going to take a longer time to treat this. Now so what else also happens is when you don't complete the course. Why does an antibiotic always have a course? Okay, it's because the antibiotic needs a certain amount of time to overcome the bacterial load in the body, and the doctor will always call you before your antibiotic course is over for a checkup, so that they would know whether they need to continue it for longer or not. Okay, so if you suppose you're taking an antibiotic, it's given to you for 5 days. After the third day you start feeling better and you decide to stop that antibiotic. Now what happens is that there is still leftover bacteria in your body, okay, in your system, which has now escaped, and that bacteria will also start forming DNA. It will start mutating, so that the next time you use that antibiotic, it knows how to maneuver past it, and it will become resistant to that antibiotic. So again, you will have a relapse of the infection, and this time of course it's going to take much longer to take care of it, and it will need another type of antibiotic which could obviously number one it prolong the course of the illness. Of course, it will also increase the cost of treatment, because you're not following the treatment, so you will have to keep going for treatment. And as you go to higher usage of higher antibiotics, of course, the cost of treatment increases as well. Another thing in antibiotic resistance, you did not complete the course, so the bacteria has become resistant to that particular antibiotic. And what you can do also is, not only it's causing harm to yourself, it also it can spread to your family, etc. You know, it's an infection. So if that resistant bacteria now spreads to someone else, and then to someone else, and to someone else, now we have an entire cycle. We have an entire new generation of that bacteria that's formed, which is resistant to certain antibiotics. Okay, so we already have a lot of strains of bacteria that have become resistant to antibiotics, and it's extremely difficult to treat these infections, and we have to work really hard to kind of actually stamp out these infections. And scientists are constantly working to come out with newer antibiotics to combat these new super bugs, as they are called, because they are resistant to so many antibiotics which were commonly used before, but they have learned how to become resistant to them because of overuse or because of incorrect use of these antibiotics. Now another thing is, now suppose you have a cold which is again viral, and you decide, I'm going to take this antibiotic which my doctor had given me previously for another infection, or which was given to my brother or sister, etc., for another infection. I'm just going to take it because there's some antibiotic left over. Now that is also another cause, because you're improperly using that antibiotic. It's not the same infection that your relative or anybody, your neighbor, could have had. It's the same thing when it comes to your animals. Now your dog has a ear infection. You just pick up whichever drops are available, which your vet might have given you previously, and you just start putting those drops. You put them for 2 days, your dog gets better, and you stop. But what you're doing is breeding and causing that bacteria to mutate. It's going to try to find new ways to overcome this antibiotic so that it can survive. Okay, so when you just randomly put drops, etc., in the ears without consulting your vet, or just put it randomly for 2 days and then stop, because you think it's better, you're actually adding to the problem. And where we have had cases with dogs with such severe ear infection, and none of the antibiotics are working on it because the bacteria has just become so resistant from constantly having those drops being put. It's become resistant to those antibiotics, and you know, it's difficult to find certain antibiotics that actually work on it. And in some cases, when we even do a culture, now a culture is when we actually get the bacteria, we take a swab we take a swab and we send it to the lab, we actually grow the bacteria and we attack it with different antibiotics and see, that's a culture and sensitivity test. So we see which antibiotic the bacteria is sensitive to, which antibiotic can actually get rid of it. So when we do this, we a lot of times find out that a simple bacteria is actually resistant to these multiple antibiotics that are so easily available, and that are the least toxic antibiotics that are available, and we have to go for the higher generation antibiotics, and a lot of them do have I would say more toxic side effects than their counterparts. So in a lot of cases we do have to use those because we don't have a choice. So please do not use randomly any ear drops or any antibiotics that has been left over from, you know, you have a strip of 10, you used only 8, 2 are left. So, okay, let's just try and use this and see if it works. Do not do that, because you will be adding to much larger problem. And this is not only a problem for animals, it's a problem for humans, it's a problem for the entire planet. Alright, antibiotic resistance is something that is looming, and it's a lot of doctors do talk about it. So whenever you even go to your doctor for yourself, please speak to them about antibiotic resistance. Okay, and antibiotics are our friends. Okay, these are life-saving drugs. So it's best that we don't overuse or misuse them in any way. So that is something that is so important in today's day and age when we talk about antibiotics. Antibiotics are not here to harm you. They're actually here to save lives. Okay, so don't be afraid of them when they are prescribed for a certain reason. So don't stop taking them thinking it's going to harm you. You have to finish the course as described, as prescribed by your doctor. This is for pets and for yourself as well. Okay, there is a reason why there is an entire course of these antibiotics. So always finish that course. And before you stop the antibiotics, please speak to your doctor, speak to your vet to see if it is the right thing to do, or if you need to continue it for longer because of any reason, that maybe the infection hasn't completely gone, if there are still some remnants of infection. Okay, which you might not be able to tell, because physically it might look better, but you know, the blood picture, or your vet obviously is not trained to tell you if the infection has completely gone or not. So that is something to do responsibly, and it'll also help to reduce antibiotic resistance. Also, another way to reduce antibiotic resistance, of course, is prevention. So a way obviously to prevent infections is to maintain hygiene. Okay, always wash your hands, keep everything clean. So that is another way to, of course, it'll obviously reduce the usage of antibiotics in general. And in that way, we can also prevent antibiotic resistance from occurring. We need to save these drugs for the bacteria that they're actually going to work against. So a lot of times what we do like to do is do a culture sensitivity to know which bacteria, which antibiotic we're going to use exactly for that infection, so that we don't blindly just prescribe antibiotics or use them wrongly, which would lead to antibiotic resistance. Okay, so another thing to just clarify is that your body is not resistant to that antibiotic. It is that particular bacteria which is in your body that is resistant to the antibiotic. Alright, and another thing, again, I would just reiterate, if it's a common cold, flu, etc., which is caused by viruses, antibiotics do not work on these. So please speak to your doctor before you decide to go and pick up antibiotics. Unfortunately, in our country, antibiotics are easily available over the counter and they shouldn't be. So always, always follow a prescription whenever it comes to antibiotics. Always complete the prescription, follow it to the T, and please go for a recheck so that you know you followed that course correctly and you have recovered correctly, so that you know we know that everything is all right and we're not causing any other issues in your body or in your pet's body as well. Alright, if anyone has any questions about antibiotic resistance, please feel free to ask. I will also be putting this video up on YouTube, it's going to be on IGTV, it's going to be on Facebook as well. So if you would like to share this video, of course, because this I feel is a very important topic that is that we are talking about. And when it comes to veterinary science, which also includes the meat industry and the milk industry, please, whenever you buy meat or milk, make sure that you read and know that where your meat or milk is coming from. Make sure that it is antibiotic free, because meat and milk has also been the cause of antibiotic resistance, because a lot of times there is an irresponsible use of antibiotics in these animals, so that they use it as a preventive or just, you know, so that the animals stay healthy before they are slaughtered or before they are used for milk. So when you do this, please make sure that you're buying antibiotic free meat or antibiotic free milk. So that, because even there are residual antibiotics that remain in meat and milk, which can cause antibiotic resistance when we consume it. So always look at what you're buying and make sure you're getting it from a responsible source. Alright, and I think that's it for antibiotic resistance. Just be responsible whenever you take antibiotics. Follow the advice of your doctor, follow the advice of your vet. Do not blindly use antibiotics, ear drops, eye drops, because they were given previously or you have some left over. Speak to your vet about whether you need to stop the antibiotic or continue it. Okay, even when that's why the doctor will give you a 5-day course and call you back for a checkup after 5 days, so that we know that everything is okay and you're okay to stop the antibiotic, okay? Or if the infection hasn't cleared, you need to continue it for longer. So responsible use of these drugs. Do not overuse, underuse. Do not stop it. If you've started feeling better after 2 doses, don't just suddenly stop it. There are reasons for these courses, okay? There are reasons why there are certain bacteria that has become a problem in society right now, and it will continue to be. We will continue to get these super bugs unless we are more responsible with ourselves, with our pets, and with what we are doing. So please take care of yourselves, take care of your pets, and if you have any more questions about this, please let me know. And I hope you guys have a great day ahead and a good evening. And it was so nice having all of you. And thank you for listening. So bye-bye, everybody. Thank you.